Hi there! Welcome to this video dedicated to CorelDRAW X7. We will see here all you need to start creating in a very short time. Please leave us feedbacks to improve our videos. Before starting, remember that you have the hints window on your right, in case you are in distress with something. In case you have it closed, you can always open it again, going to Window above and then to Dockers. Do this in case Windows miss. Create a new project. Just click on the icon that looks like a sheet of paper on the left. Here you can decide name, width and height, orientation and number of pages. Instead of using custom width and height values, make sure to use standard values. You can choose them going to sides. This is important in case your project has to be printed or be uploaded in a website later. Let's see the workspace. On top you have different bars. The menu bar, that is the classic bar that contains all the features of the software, the standard toolbar that contains all options regarding opening, saving and visualization, and the property bar that contains all options related to the current tool selected. On the center you have your main workspace, where you will go into work. On the left you have the toolbox that lists all the important tools accessible fast, and on the right a list of other windows we will see. Create a generic line. You can use the first icon in the third section of the toolbox. Then just click and drag to draw. You can zoom in and out using your mouse wheel, and move through your project using the pen tool, clicking and dragging. The buttons in the toolbox may have a dark arrow on the right. This means that more than one tool is listed inside a single button. You can choose the right tool holding your click on it and then selecting. The tool that you are going to activate is always the one shown by the button. So to activate the pen tool, choose the hand icon. CorelDRAW has other important tools to help you at drawing. You can enable or disable them from the standard toolbar. You can enable or disable the rules around your workspace, activate or not a grid, or the guides. Apart from the grid, it is better to keep rules and guides active to make projects more precise. You can do three main things with CorelDRAW: create your own drawings, retouch images, or create text paragraphs. All you need to create drawings is inside the third section of the toolbox on the left. The first tool collects all to draw lines and curves. Freehand Tool lets you draw freely. Just hold your click on while you draw, or else click twice to create a straight segment. 2-point line always draws a straight segment. Just hold your click and drag. Bezier, pen and B-spline lets you create curves. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. Use a 3-point curve to draw curves while you are starting using this software. Just hold your click and drag to create the initial segment. Then convert it to an arc, moving your pointer after releasing your click. Polyline draws a consecutive series of segments sharing a same node. Double click to finish drawing it. Artistic Media Tool draws artistic traces and works just like the Freehand Tool. Use the Rectangle, Ellipse and Polygon tools to draw polygons or other special shapes. Hold your click on the button to choose other ways to draw them or the kind of shape you want to insert. Lines, curves and polygons are totally created by the software and are also called vector files. Keep in mind the property bar on top. Every time a tool is active, it lets you adjust the drawing options related. For example, if you have artistic media on, you can change the kind of trace, its thickness, and so on. In case you want to import pictures and modify them, you can simply click and drag them inside from your own folder. This is also called the bitmap file, and it's fully managed through the bitmaps section in the menu bar. Just make sure to select the picture first, then go to bitmaps and then to Image Adjustment Lab to correct lightness, contrast and colors through the new window appearing. Check the preview on the left. When you are done, just click on OK below. If you don't like the settings applied, you can always undo your latest action pressing Ctrl and Z from your keyboard. You can also add effects on your picture, selecting one of these more at the bottom of the bitmaps section, and then setting how the effect must be through the related window. Bitmap files and vector files can be managed in the same way. You can select an object, clicking on it, while the pick tool, the first icon in the toolbox, is on. Editing tools always work on selected objects. You can select just one object or more of them if you click on them on and on while holding Shift down. Press Escape key to undo selections. You can cut, copy or delete any object right-clicking on it. You can click on Lock Object to block the object as it is, in case you don't want to move or edit it until you don't unlock it. You can delete parts of objects using the Eraser tool, which is inside the third buttons list. This deletes parts of vector objects and pictures, but doesn't work on artistic media traces or text. Keep in mind that, in case the object has a stroke, this will be updated. And if you cut an object in two parts, these may seem independent, but indeed, they do remain dependent, since you move and select them always together. If you want to cut parts of an image, the easiest way is to duplicate it first, and then use the Shape tool. Drag the nodes or the edges to cut off what you don't need. You can also add new nodes double-clicking to create a custom shape. Select an object and drag it to move it. If there are more objects selected, these will be all moved in the same way. Then you can use the squared black nodes to scale the object. Each object is inside a virtual box whose center is indicated through a black cross. If you click once on the object selected, the nodes become black arrows. You can use these to rotate or skew the object. You can move objects while using other tools. If you drag an object with your right mouse click and choose Move Here, you will directly move without enabling the Pick tool. While you are using the Pick tool, you can scale and place your object more precisely using the property bar, typing precise numbers. Press Enter key to apply. Moreover, you can rotate the object selected, setting the right degrees, or flip horizontally or vertically, using the two buttons more on the right. You can set other options using the object properties on the right. On top, choose the section, and then modify the stroke color, line, any transparency, some filling or gradient. Just remember that the square with its diagonal shown means no color. Use it to remove any filling or stroke applied. There are many other tools you can try. The second button collects many effects you can apply on selected objects. All these work if you click and drag the pointer on the object interested. Then you have other effect tools, like the two ones above the eyedropper tool. In these cases, you have to click and drag just once. For example, you can add shadow using the drop shadow tool. Remember to use the property bar to change the effect settings. The object properties on the right are always referred to the object itself and never on any of its effects applied. So if you need to edit the shadow in the future, you have to activate the drop shadow tool again and use the property bar, and so with any other effect. Key points are very useful while you draw and are indicated in blue color. Object edges are indicated through a square, nodes and angles through a bigger square, central points through a target, and midpoints through a triangle. Then you can add some text. Simply click on the A icon in the toolbox. Click and drag on your workspace to create a text area, a virtual rectangle that fixes the boundaries for the text inside. Click and drag on the cross to move the text. Use the black and the white nodes to size the text area. If it's too much small, the text won't be shown and the rectangle becomes red. Use the property bar to set the text properties, for example its font and size. Select the text first to make changes effective. In this case, you can also use the object properties on the right to add stroke, gradients, or set the text distribution. What if you have objects overlapped? You need to use the layers in the Object Manager window on the right. Each object is a sublayer listed in this window. In short, the object that is upper in this list is shown on all objects that stay more below. So you can choose to place the text on or behind an object, simply changing its position in the list, simply by clicking and dragging up or down. When you are done, save your project. Simply click on the Save icon on top. Choose the destination and its format. In case you save it as .cdr, you will save it as a CorelDRAW project. This can be opened again by this software to edit it further in the future. You can open this again going to Open. It will appear in another subwindow right above the workspace. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel For more amazing softwares,